You've probably heard about the Fibonacci sequence before. It starts with 0 and 1, and every new number is just the sum of the two before it. Also, did you know that there is an online encyclopedia for integer sequences? Anyway, let's see how many ways we can actually compute the nth Fibonacci number. Calculating the nth Fibonacci number is a classic example of recursion, so let's start with that. Simple enough, right? This is basically the definition of Fibonacci written down as code. But there is a catch. Take a look at the computation graph. Do you see the problem? We are recomputing the same values again and again. For example, the subtree on the left is exactly the same as the subtree on the right. And that makes recursion painfully slow. Like really slow. Computing just the 50th Fibonacci number took me more than 26 minutes. We are gonna rate each algorithm on three aspects: speed, how much space it uses, and how hard it is to implement. So how do we make recursion faster? Easy, store the results in a table as we go. This is called memoization. Every time we encounter a new Fibonacci number, we remember it, so next time we need it, we can look it up in the table and avoid wasting time recalculating it. That means we were able to remove all these nodes from the computation graph. If you look again, it's clear that sooner or later we'll need every Fibonacci number up to n. So why not just build them from the bottom? That's the iterative approach. Instead of breaking the problem apart with recursion, we just start at the beginning and work forward. Here is a neat observation about the previous approach. To get the next Fibonacci number, we only need the previous 2. That means we don't have to store the whole table, just 2 variables are enough. And just like that, we save a lot of space. Okay, next up. A bit of mathematical dark magic. If you take this matrix and raise it to the nth power, it contains the nth Fibonacci number. To implement this, we create a function for multiplying 2 by 2 matrices and another for raising a matrix to the nth power, which repeatedly multiplies the magic matrix n times in a loop. The bottleneck of the previous algorithm is the exponentiation step. Luckily, we can speed things up with something called fast exponentiation. Here's the idea. Instead of multiplying n-1 times in a row, we split the problem in half, again and again. For example, instead of multiplying 27 trees together, we can compute 3 to the 27th power as 3 times 3 to the 13th power times 3 to the 13th power. By holding the exponent like this, we cut down the number of steps dramatically. In fact, with this method, the number of multiplications drops from 26 all the way down to just 7. And the best part is, this trick works the same way with matrices. That's why matrix exponentiation with fast exponentiation is the fastest method so far. There is also an iterative version of fast exponentiation which we can use to save space. And that would be all. Except there is another one, Binet's formula, a closed form expression based on the golden ratio to jump straight to the answer. You plug in n, do some floating point math, and the nth Fibonacci number appears. The only issue is that it doesn't always work. Floating point numbers have limited precision, so the method eventually drifts away from the true values. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button and subscribe for more. See you in the next one.